Hi everyone, it's Kristen from the Distance Depot. I'm going to hopefully take the mystery out of the difference between the Toclat woolback material and the Toclat coolback material. People always want to know what's the difference and what is better. So I hope to explain a little bit about that. The woolback is Toclat's version of wool. It's only available in the creamy wool color. It's super easy to keep clean. It's funny because people are always worried, well, it's so light colored, isn't it going to get dirty? Yes, I suppose it is, but these saddle pads dry super fast. They wear like iron. They're machine washable, so you can throw them in the wash. I just turn mine inside out. I never use Tide. I've seen laundry detergent burn horses' backs, so I always tell folks to be super careful. Use just a drop, double rinse if you're using soap, so that you don't run the risk of burning your horse's back. But I just throw them in the wash. Again, they wear like iron. I shake them out and just turn them upside down, let them dry in the sun, and they dry super quickly. Like, you can do 50 miles, get done with your ride, and do 50 miles the next day. Your pad is definitely dry. It dries in a matter of hours. It's very quick. So those are some of the nice properties of the woolback. The wool is said to have little tiny barbs in it, if you will, that grab onto the hair and help keep your saddle in place. So also a nice feature of the woolback. There are a couple of different styles. We do offer a dressage, oversized woolback, and also an all-purpose. These two pads here are our most popular pads. The top pad in the image, the smaller one, is the Toclat woolback barrel pad. The bottom pad that I have here is the Toclat oversized endurance pad. It's a high profile pad, raised up in the withers, which is nice, although I'm sure all of us always pull our saddle pad up into the gullet to help relieve any wither pressure. But this pad is contoured. And as you can see, it has a lot more coverage. I like this extra coverage for my leg. It helps my leg not get so gooey. And also it protects the horse's rib cage. So where your girth rigging is or your fender, it just offers more coverage. I suppose the top one might be a little bit cooler. So it just depends. Do you need more coverage for your girth rigging or your saddle skirt, if you will? We do list all of the sizes of our saddle pads on the website. So if you find the picture of the product you're after and you click on it, that there will bring you to more information about the pad or product that you're interested in, and of course give you the size of the saddle pad. But as you can clearly see, the endurance pad is bigger than the barrel pad, even though both of them have rounded barrel shapes to them. We do have a Western woolback too, and it's square. So getting to the difference of the coolback, is a hospital grade synthetic, and it's available in colors. So we have white and royal blue, red and brown, purple, navy blue, lamb, and what other colors? Burgundy and hunter green. So a super nice pad, probably a little easier. You may not see quite as much dirt. We sell probably equal amounts of woolback and coolbacks. It's hard to say, but if you think about it, like, our U.S. riders are typically riding in red or blue. So people will say, well, is one better than the other? I guess it's all dependent on you and your horse, how long you're out there. I prefer the woolback myself, but we have plenty of customers using the colored pads. They also are machine washable. The nice thing about those two is you can use color safe bleach. So if you're putting the pad on different horses. If you have several horses that you're working, the bleach is nice just to help not spread any skin stuff if that were to occur. So it is nice to have that. As you can see, I don't put any wear leathers on our saddle pads, and the reason for that is because we have a lot of riders doing XP rides where they're riding many days in a row. So they actually are flipping their saddle pads, so they have a clean pad throughout those 6 days. So that's the reason for no wear leathers. I like that. And I don't find that they need straps at the bottom for the girth rigging. We haven't seen a lot of slippage. These pads seem to stay very well placed underneath the saddle. If you have any questions, feel free to call the Distance Depot and we'll be happy to walk you through any questions you might have about the saddle pads. Thanks for tuning in. Enjoy your convention.